at that time. And I don't think the judicial branch of government should ever allow politics to play into their decision making, and I think they did in Casey.
If Roe is overturned to allow your law to be enacted, do you plan on pursuing even more restrictions, or are you going to stop at 15 weeks? Because there's a tighter restriction at one time, a trigger law that was on the books. Do you want to see something like that if Roe is overturned?
Well, I certainly would like to do everything we can to protect unborn children, but let's put this in perspective, Chuck. You know, in Europe, there are 42 countries that allow elective abortions. If Roe is overturned and this 15-week ban in Mississippi is allowed to go into effect, Mississippi will still have a law on the books in which 39 countries, 39 out of 42 in Europe, have more restrictive abortion laws mm-hmm. than what I believe to be one of the most conservative states in the United States. 39 countries in Europe restrict abortions earlier than 15 weeks. And so the reality is that the U.S. abortion laws are not in conformity or are not even in the realm of what we see in other parts of the country. When you look at, for instance, abortion laws yeah. in California and New York, they are much more similar to those abortion laws in China and North Korea than they are to Europe or many other countries around the world.
I want to play something that you said about the vaccine mandate and ask you why the same philosophy doesn't apply here. Let me play what you said.
This is a power grab by the federal government. We've seen this time and time again by the Biden administration, and now we're seeing their strong desire to try to make decisions on behalf of individual Americans. We believe in freedom and individual liberty.
Freedom and individual liberty. Why should the state of Mississippi tell a woman what they should do with their body? Why shouldn't they have that individual freedom on their body, particularly in the first 20 weeks?
Well, this is a prime example, and the far left loves to scream, "My body, my choice." And what I would submit to you, Chuck, is they absolutely ignore the fact that in getting an abortion, there is an actual killing of an innocent unborn child that is in that womb. Here's what we know about babies that are 15 weeks. We know that they have a heartbeat. We know that those babies at 15 weeks actually can open and close their hands. We know that they have developing lungs. And we know that those babies at 15 weeks can feel pain. And so when you talk, the difference between vaccine mandates and abortions is vaccines allow you to protect yourself. Abortions actually go in and kill other American babies. And let's just put this in perspective.
But Governor, Chuck, vaccines are not about yourself. Governor, hang on a minute. A vaccine is about protecting a larger community. A vaccine is about preventing spread. You could argue a vaccine mandate is a pro-life position.
You could certainly argue that, Chuck, but even if you listen to Dr. Fauci's interview with you earlier today, he made it very clear that the vaccine may not keep you from getting the virus. It may not keep you from spreading the virus, but it can keep you from ending up in the hospital. That's what's been proven during this Delta surge that we've seen in America, is that the virus is continuing to being spread even amongst those who are vaccinated. Conversely, when you're talking about the pro-life position of protecting unborn babies, let's put it also in perspective. The fact is that during this very horrible and challenging time since I was sworn into office in January of 2020, Chuck, we've had 800,000 American lives lost because of COVID. And my heart aches for every single one of those individuals that has died because of COVID. Over 10,000 Mississippians, my heart breaks for every single one of them. But since Roe was enacted, 62 million American babies have been aborted and have therefore been killed. And that's why I think it's very important that people like myself and others across this country stand up for those unborn children, because they don't have the ability to stand up for themselves.
Governor Tate Reeves, Republican of Mississippi, I appreciate you coming on and sharing your perspective with us, sir. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Chuck.